everyone, happy Friday. So I've had a really busy day and I haven't had a chance to film another Friday focus video. So I went to Twitter and just kind of gave everyone an update, you know, that it wasn't coming. And my friend Joy from Australia, she tweeted back and said, hey, why don't you show us some of your Copic coloring, some little doodads and people that you've been coloring. So here I am, and I'm just gonna show you guys really quick. It's gonna be a really fast video. So this first one is, in fact, let me zoom in for you. This is a little, it's a digital image from the Greeting Farm Halloween Witch, I think it's called. Anyway, and I just bought the digital image, printed it out on some, let's see, let me fill this. Yeah, this is Express It Blend cardstock, blending cardstock, and colored it in. I love the reds in her hair. Did I write down? I think I have an image that I took with my cell phone of the numbers on the markers before I cut it out. So I'll insert that here if I have it. All right. And then I have this little girl right here. This is also from the Greeting Farm. I think this is CC Tuesday. And I put some glitter over her crown. I colored it in with Copic markers and then covered it with Stardust Stickles. Actually, I think it's Diamond Stickles. Yeah, Diamond Stickles, because I still wanted a little bit of that gradient. So, and I want it to show through. So that's why I didn't use a yellow stickle specifically. All right, here's another Halloween dude. This is a Paper Smooches little guy, little Frankenstein. He's got some glossy eyes. So cute. This is another Greeting Farm, and I covered her rain boots and her buttons and her little rain hat. I guess that's what you call it, a rain hat, with glossy accents. And I wanted to use black enamel on her buttons, but I don't have black enamel yet. I've ordered it. I'm waiting for it to arrive. So I just colored the buttons in black and then covered it with glossy accents. And there's actually quite a bit of dimension to them because I had to get it all in one spot. So I think she's super cute. I want to kind of make a card, something about rainy day or something, and then have glossy accent raindrops. I think it'd be really cute. So here is a little wedding image, and I actually want to use this on the final wedding card for the wedding series. So this is sort of fitting since I'm using doing this video instead of that video. So anyway, I colored, I don't even remember. I didn't write down the colors I used on this one, so unfortunately I can't let you know. But I did cover the her flowers right there, and then her trim and her bow and the trim on her dress with, I think this one was Stardust Stickles to get kind of that really clear, glittery look. So I thought that'd be really, really cute little wedding card piece. And then I have this little bird dude. I think he's so funny. Covered his eyes in glossy accents as well, like I like to do with these little cartoon images. This is a Paper Smooches stamp. And then these last two, I'm actually putting on a card that I'm working on for Simon Says Stamp right now for their blog. These are Cosmo Cricket stamps from their latest, what is it, Jolly Day collection, I think. And these are going to go on a little card that's going up on the Simon Says Stamp blog on Sunday. So little sneak peek, you guys are going to check it out on Sunday. So here are my little dudes that I've been collecting and coloring and collecting. And I have lots more images that I found online that I'm going to be coloring. And I don't know that I'm going to do like specific how-to videos on them for how to color them. I might in the future. I'm not really sure. But this is just what I've been doing recently. And if any of you guys are new to Copic coloring or you just want to get better at coloring, practice. Like, that is the one thing I can tell you guys to do, is just to keep practicing. And if you can, buy digital images online, because they're usually like, you know, $3 to $4 a piece, and you can print them out multiple times really quickly on one sheet of paper. And then you can actually like have them side by side. Like, here, let me show you. I'm not going to edit this video, so, because I don't have time, but I'm going to show you guys what I have. Let me zoom out. Okay, so I just have this little packet that has a little zipper on the top, and I've got all of my little images in there to practice. So let me pull them out. All right, so see, like on this one, I started with saying, oh, the light's coming from here. I was trying to figure out the shading. Started to color it, didn't like how it was going, so I'm not sure what I'm doing with that. Cute little skater girl. Got a little she-devil. I think she's so funny. From the greeting farm. And then a couple of these kind of Christmas images. And a witch and a couple witches. Here's some practicing. So if I wanted to, I could still cut this girl out. But she was actually the first time I colored her, and then I colored her again with these colors instead, because I thought she would be really pretty with like red hair and a green dress. And I started coloring her trying to see what I could do if I gave her some different colored hair. So that's what that is. And then this one, this is the first time I tried a specific hair coloring technique that I found online. I think I found it in a YouTube video. I'll have to track it down and share it with you guys sometime. I don't remember where it was at the moment, but this is the first time I did that hair technique, and I loved how it turned out. She's got kind of that like light auburn hair. I think it's so cute. Up here is when I was trying to figure out yellows that would work together on this little girl right here. And so, you know, if you're just learning and you're trying to figure things out, don't be afraid to stamp it twice or print it out twice and color it a couple different times, because you'll get a better result each time you do. So anyway, that is, let's see, do I have any more? Oh, here's one where I printed out this, or not printed, these are actual stamps. I used her on a card in an online class. And then, let's see. This is a little girl that I drew myself with Copic markers. This is like growing up and in high school and even a little bit at work when I wasn't working at home. When I'd be in meetings, I would like draw people, and this is kind of my little style, like how they would always look. So this one looks like my little niece. So there's her. I also colored this witch. That's a paper smooches stamp. And I have a bunch of these started. Like, I started to color this girl's hair and it was not going well, so I stopped. and then I just have a bunch of other little stamped images, like from paper smooches, that I'm going to color at some point. I don't know when. So this is what I've been doing recently with all my Copic coloring. Oh, here's another one that I did myself. I named her Margaret because I think she kind of looks a little bit nerdy, and I think she seems like a Margaret to me. Not to say that Margaret's are nerdy, but I just labeled her Margaret. I think she would go by Maggie. And then here's one that's a little bit more of a realistic style, but not, because her eyes are huge. And then I colored a couple cows. So I don't know what I'm ever going to do with all of these. I might cut them out and put them on cards, but for now, this is just my little collection of practicing my Copic coloring. My Copic marker collection has grown exponentially in the last few weeks. So anyway, thanks for watching. Sorry, this video went a lot longer than I thought it would, but hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.